Welcome back, she bros and he bros. He bros and she bros. Tell you what, me and this phone, I'm finna throw it out the window. Well, if you notice, in about 14 minutes, I'll put my seatbelt on here, getting on the highway. I'm turn the camera around. No, I'm not frustrated. I'm in a good mood. My last video, which will be titled, What Have We Learned? This will be part two. Decided to shut off around 14 minutes, 40 seconds. Not shut off, but just the sound went away. Why? Help me. Jiminy Christmas. Okay, what I was talking about was, at the end of that one was, CNN, ABC, NBC, even Fox News are lying to us. They're not telling us the truth. ABC got busted, or NBC got busted the other day, posting a picture or a video from Italy of inside of a hospital, claiming it was a U.S. hospital. They got busted on it, and they said, oh, we apologize. We ran the wrong clip. Okay, well, regardless of whether you ran the wrong clip or not, you were still talking about the same thing, that our hospitals were overrun. Where's the clip you were supposed to run? Play these games with me? I ain't stupid. Come on now. It's utterly ridiculous what we're being told. What is the agenda behind it? Power grab's all I got for right now. They're fixed to take away a whole lot of our civil rights. And we're going to sit down, we're going to take it. I watched the comments on my state page where the governor speaks. And oh my, it makes me want to puke. Governor Lujan, you are the greatest governor this state has ever had. Other states would be lucky to have you. Ah, blah, blah. Oh, I just want to kiss your feet. I want to rub your butt. Oh, you're so beautiful, Ms. Lujan. I want to puke at them comments. I told them yesterday, I said, you know what? Every one of you idiots are going to run down there to the courthouse lawn and beg for them to take your rights away. You're going to beg for them to take your guns away. And you're going to beg to take the mark of the beast. Gladly. I have one comment come back. You're a weird dude. You damn right I'm a weird dude. I am nothing like you people in this world. I am set apart, holy and righteous, according to my Yahweh. Oh, he said he was holy and righteous. That's right, and repentful. I repent more than I'm righteous. Bet that. But I walk in righteousness because I walk according to the ways of Yahweh. And when I'm wrong, I repent. Which happens quite often. Doing the best I can with what I have with where I'm at. That's what you all should be doing. Oh, boy. Anyway, that would have pretty well ended that last video, but let's just go ahead and continue to... if we're going to make a part two. 3 minutes ain't much. What else do we got? So, the other side of the story. This is what they say it is. It is what we see happening in Italy and I guess Spain is getting beat up pretty good. It is what they say it is. And we have the government that has put in place certain stipulations to protect the American people. Now, granted, this would be the first time in about 75 years that the government actually thought about the American people when they did something. But, hey, you know, there's the first time for everything. You feel me? Ronald Reagan said it best when he said, the scariest words you'll ever hear is, I'm from the government, I'm here to help. You better run. That's what you better do. Maybe that's what puts me on the defensive. I know what my government's capable of. I know that the American people are the last thing on their list of ideas to care about. Why would they do all this just to crash the economy? I don't know. Maybe it's a cover-up because the economy was bound to crash. It was a bubble. Study economics, you look at bubbles and they grow and then they burst. When they burst, they fall. Anything propped up by that bubble falls along with it. The housing market, 2008, go study that one. Look what it did to our economy. Look what it did to us nationwide. So that's why I'm just looking at this like, I don't know what y'all trying to do, but I don't trust you. You know, it's like a snake in my house. I know that I'm laid up next to that boa constrictor's laid up next to me, not because he wants to stay warm. He's looking to see if he can eat me. You feel me? That's what I feel the government is doing right now. They're sizing themselves up to see if they can eat us. All the way back to 2000, well, all the way back then. Go back to 2015 during J-Down, when they were going to put military occupation on the streets as a drill. Look what the American patriots responded with. Anger, hatred. It was all out hell on the internet for that 6 months, talking about that J-Down. I believe that was a psyop to test and see what the American people, where they stood. I believe they got their intel. They put into place what we see today. Surely they wouldn't do all that. You don't know what the American government's capable of. You don't know what the elites are capable of if you believe that they are doing this for our good. Look at vaccinations. It costs you absolutely nothing to go get a vaccine. It's free. Boom, go get one. Ooh, and we push it. But go get a vial of insulin. How come a vial of insulin costs me $350 where I can just go get a flu shot free anywhere I want to go? Pick it. Walgreens, Walmart, CVS. You name it. Free flu shots. If it's bad for you, they give it to you for free. If it could do harm to you, they give it to you for free. But if it's something you need, oh no, we got to charge for. How about giving up this insulin shots for free? More people die of diabetes every year than, well, I guess the flu is supposed to be 80,000 dies of the flu. I'm starting to wonder if that's not bullshit. You feel where I'm coming from. You got to open your eyes. And I know that many of you who follow me regularly do. I'm talking to the new people on here that maybe you're on the fence. Is it or isn't it? Like I've said, I don't know. Protect yourself. Do your own research, your own due diligence. Study it out and do the best you can do with what you have, with where you're at for your family at this given moment. We're reading in Isaiah, the shofar shall blow. When the shofar blows, you will know it's time to fight. Right now, it's time to gather intel. Every war that's ever been won, there was a ton of intel gathered before the war ever began. You better be gathering intel right now. That's what I can tell you. That's what I'm certain of. It's been a long time since I had my head this far up in the government's behind, seeing what they were doing. Back before I followed Christ and I was a diehard 3%er constitutionalist, and I could quote you verbatim the U.S. Constitution, the Bill of Rights. I could quote them verbatim. I'm a little bit rusty on them. I know what they are, but I'm more concerned with what Yeshua can do for me rather than what my government can do for me. You feel me? Psalms 91, I push it all the time. Read it 3 times a day, morning, noon, and night. Eat it for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Yea, thee who resides in the shelter of the Most High. Find the secret place in the shelter of the Most High, and then you'll find salvation.
He's talking about works-based theology.
No, I'm not. Salvation comes. Not because of me, but because of Him. What I do with that is up to me. Can I lose my salvation? No. If I could, absolutely, I'd do it as soon as I got it. So would you. Adam did. Satan did. So everybody who claims, oh, you can't lose your salvation, to what happened to Adam? He lost his salvation. Did he? He fell. Did he repent? We don't really know. We know that his children were taught to give sacrifices to the Lord. I say he repented. Just my theory on what I understand. I guess I ought to give a teaching on that one of these days. Anyway, probably confused the hell out of y'all just now. What is it? Can we lose it or can we not? Stick with me. Subscribe to my channel. We're going to continue to read the scriptures every day. We're going to hear what God says about this. Not what man says about it. Not what Pastor Matt says about it. Not what Oldfield Disciple says about it or any other pastor. What does God say about it? That's a fact, and that's for certain. Y'all be blessed, be encouraged, and always be frustrated. This is Oilfield Disciple. I will catch you on the next ride.